So, welcome to another Sergius Development Podcast, and it's a second part of getting multi-select working in Harbor Falcat in my file management application for Sergius. So we will start where we ended up in the last part by basically having the multi-select bar ready and open it up. And yeah, what we want to do first of all is close the multi-select bar when I hit the close button. I think this makes sense, doesn't it? So, multi-select bar, let's see, we have a cancel button here, or close button basically, and what we do right now is just cancel. What we want to do is cancel the multi-select stuff, so what we will do is just simply unclicked, as you can see here. Multi-select is enabled, or it opens up if multi-select is enabled, so what we will do is just set multi-select to false. And this should be it. Usually it should be it, because what it will do, of course, if you close it, you want to also remove all the... let me show you just simply this in the emulator. So we have here right now the multi-select bar, and we have different selections. And if I just close out of it right now by going here, if I go back to the select mode, so make it visible again, go to multi-select, you can see I have all my three files in multi-select mode again. Is this what we really want to do? If we hit the close button here, I don't think so. If we hit the close button here, what should happen is that all the selections should be gone as well. So there are a few things that we have to do there for achieving this. First of all is, if I click here, I have to remove them from the clipboard. So what I will do here is just simply also say clipboard clear. So we clear every entrance of a clipboard, which is, I think, very, very important, so that we have this clipboard empty of all the files. The other thing is, of course, a little bit more complicated, as we have in our open dialog, we have our elements, our file item delegates that have this selection, mselect stuff. And yeah, how do we get this selection out of the thing? What we could do is just simply reload the dialog for getting rid of the selections that we have. So this is, I think, the idea that I have. So what I want to do in multi-select bar is also to take a look in open dialog, how is it called? I think something like file model. Exactly, file model. Ah, we have file model and we have file model hidden. So hidden. So we have to have both stuff where we have, we just change the path to something and change it back to the path. This is, I think, the easiest method for reloading stuff, because they don't have, for the list model, I think they don't have a reload option. Let's check it with F1. We have a sort, we have a get, we have an index out, we have an is folder, but we don't have a reload option. So what we'll simply do is just simply reload stuff. So file model path, we'll save this into old path, and then we will set file model path to empty, and then file model path to old path again. And in theory, we have to do this the same with file model hill, but no, we don't have to do it. We have here, we have a path option, isn't it? So yes, we have a page path option that we can use. So let's do it like this, so we don't have to edit the stuff directly into the... This should work as well, and should work on both file models. So let's close this and try it to see if it is working. theory it should work, I think. We'll see if it will work or not. So, let's see. Go into selection mode. We have this. Let's select this and this. So documents, music and videos. And if I click now on close. Okay, the selection is gone. Let's mark RPMs maybe. Select. Yeah, and it worked. As you can see here, only RPMs are now selected. So this is exactly what I want to do. And you can see the reload stuff of the folder, you don't really see it. It's just disappearing the bar and the markings. So now we have the cancel stuff done, which is nice. So let's close this. What do we do now is cut, copy and delete. This will be more interesting because what we have to do somehow is, of course, if we copy something, we have to either open up the new open dialog, so new folder basically, if you click on copy, to say where we want to paste it, or we just say, okay, we have a multi-copy stuff now going on. And what we will do now when we hit copy here is putting our stuff that we want to copy or cut. In this case, cut is nothing else than copy and then delete the original file. How do we do this? The same goes with delete. How do we do this with delete? Delete will be a bit more complicated, I would say. We have to do some new stuff. But when it comes to copy, I want to just reuse the copy thing that I already have. So let me start this right now. If I want to copy something, you can see I have a copy option here. And if I go into the folder here, here I have the option paste documents in this case, so it will just, and this is I think the way to go. What I want to do is just simply, if you have, let's go, gonna go back with the gesture. If I have select mode here and have two stuff marked here, two files or folders marked, what I want to do is hit the copy button, and what it should do right now is then hide the multi-select bar completely, and then in paste I should have both of those documents then inside. So not sure if I put in paste and then in brackets the names of all the files, maybe just paste multi-select or something, that, and then if I go here to downloads and I hit paste, I can paste both documents in. This is what I want to do at least. So how do I achieve this? I have to take a look at how I did the copy stuff. So let me check the file item delegate. Therefore, we have to check the file item delegate by checking what copy is doing. There we have copy. It is doing a BG delegate copy. So we have another copy somewhere. There we have the copy. It is it's setting the move mode to false for our FM object, and then setting the source URL to file path. So what do we do right now then? With this we have to have have to somehow, because we're just setting one file path here to the source URL, but because we have multiple URLs that you have to copy, you have to do something like this. So what would be the elegant way to do it? The elegant way to do it would be just saying that the copy function will put the file path into our clipboard as only one file, and then on pasting we will just paste the stuff that we really want to paste. I think this would be the most sane way to do that. So what we need to do now is just simply, because we're using the file path here, what we have to do is not putting it directly into the source URL. What we have to do with the file path here, because it's for the single file copy or directory copy, is put it on our on our clipboard. So what I will do is just put the append it to our clipboard. So use the add function, path and name is what it needs. So we'll just simply put clipboard add and then file path and file name, and then we have it on our clipboard. And what I would want to do now is just set the FM source URL to the clipboard get function, and we want to get the first entry, because we only have one entry in this clipboard. Do we have one entry in this clipboard? Yes, we should only have one entry in this clipboard, because when I hit the close button on the multi-select, it would remove everything from the clipboard. So we only have one thing in the clipboard. We'll add it to clipboard. What we do with the clipboard is then just set the FM source URL to clipboard get 0, because we only have one thing in there, and then how's it called? It is called source. So this should work, and we have to do the same, of course, for the move function. So we will do this now also for the move function. The only thing that's different here is that we set the move mode to true. Maybe I could do another kind of function to and now I'm just thinking about, maybe this is wrong, setting the FM source to this, is it? We'll see. Let's leave it like this. What I want to do is just simply this is the first thing that I want to do, and what I want to do is just simply close this, test if this will work. For this, do I have a terminal here? I don't have a terminal here. For this I want to create some files to simply test out if this copy and paste stuff is working or not. And what I can do here to create some files is, of course, what do we have here to create files? Is there something to create files? Not really. So what I have to do is just simply open up a terminal. Open up a terminal, and then I can SSH into the emulator. Forgot how to do this. SSHmare let's see if there's something written in the tutorial stuff here. How can I search this? Somebody searching this one. Let's go to Sailfish Silica. No, it's not SDK terminal. Uh, So there are some information here, how to use a selfish app in your project, custom context property, is something else, how to connect your terminal. If it isn't, then we can simply search here, selfish SDK connect SSH. And there's a tutorial as well on selfish.org and a wiki where you can write your own app and so on. And this should have some kind of let's search for SSH here. Yeah, we have something cheat sheet, which is also very nice to have if you want to do certain things. Here's this MassDK chroot. You can use this for chrooting into your environment if you like to. But there was a simpler way of doing this. Search for MassDK. Sometimes it takes a while to find it. Here it is. Building packages managers manually. There you can find stuff, how to do stuff, and then how to SSH into the SDK, and then you can SSH into the emulator. Moving installing package manually. Then log in the machine. I think this should work out if I'm not completely mistaken. So let's try it. I have a terminal here. Open. Oops. Why is it not working? Okay, I did it already, as you can see. This is why something stuff changed. Remove it with this command. And then try it again. Say yes. And now we are in our emulator. As root, of course. Then you can go in home memo and you can see all the files, and I can say touch doc.txt, and now we see the doc.txt here. And yeah, so I created a file, and what I want to do now is just simply copy this file into documents, and this worked without any issue. And cut this file and put it to downloads, and this worked as well. So as you can see here, the thing that I programmed here is working, so this is solid, it's working. So what I want to do now is we have to overwrite the paste option. The paste option is in Open Dialog. Let's search for paste. There we have the paste menu entry, and what it's doing is simply being visible if the FM source URL is not empty or undefined, and then it will say paste and then try to find the name of the file. And when it's clicked, it says busy running true, because you know, copy and pasting stuff or even moving stuff can be busy, and what it will do now is fm copy file from fm source URL to the path, so the findful path file, the current folder path, and then the name, of course, as well, of the source URL. So what we have to do here right now is it should not use the source URL. What it should use is the our clipboard source and name. So what we can do now is just simply what I want to do is comment this out. First of all, copy, comment this out, paste it to modify it. So the FM source URL is not what we want to use. We want to use a for loop here for I zero. How's the for loop done? We have a for loop in here. So this is our for loop is done. Let's copy this for loop for I zero I count. In this case, the count of clipboard count. Oops. I plus plus. That's okay. And it should then start the copy process for what does fm copy file have to check this fm helper it is source URL bum, bum, bum. Yeah, what I want to check is the copy file process. Copy file process. This is a copy file process. It takes a string, and another string is a target. And yeah, it connects the finish and then CP finished and run this CP file. It's running CP file source target. CP file is here, and it takes a string and a target and creates a huge file info, so this is working, so it's not using anything like the source FM source URL stuff. It's not using this one, so it's just taking the strings anyway. So what I can do is here just simply say then clipboard get I dot source. And it has to find the base name. It does not need to find the base name for this because I know the name. It is in clipboard get I dot name. Yeah. See what we save in. Yeah, name. Yeah. And this should work then as well. And of course, after copying is finished, so it's doing this for all the stuff that's in our clipboard, after copying is finished, it should then clear again our clipboard. So after pasting is finished, it should clear our clipboard. So clipboard clear. This is what it should do. I think if I don't did a great mistake right now, I can stop this right now here, execute it again and see if this will work out. So if this will work out, it's a big step forward into getting multi-select copy, cut and paste working, because it will then just iterate through our clipboard stuff and then copy stuff in one by one. what it should do. Let's see. We have our dock here, we have our dock here. Let's cut this out of here and paste it in here. It is here. See downloads, it's gone here. And let's copy from documents to downloads. And this seems to work as well. Ah, that's interesting. I think I chose copy, didn't I? Not cut. Okay, I chose cut. So copy and cut is working with our new implementation. We have some kind of errors here. Info banner, error JSON pass, error in places panel. Okay, this we can ignore for now, so it's working. It's nice, isn't it? This is really nice. Ah, this is so nice. So this is working. So the only thing that we need to do now is, we can remove this one here. The only thing that we need to do now is try it out with our multi-select bar. So if I have hit the copy button, it should do the same thing that as it did with our the copy function here. There's a copy function here. There's no copy function here. It's in file item delegate. Here we have the copy function. So it's setting FMO mode to false, and clipboard is, it doesn't need to add something. The only thing that it needs to do is set the FM source URL. This is only for getting the name right. Do I need this for multi-copy stuff? Or should I just put in FM source URL multiple files? Maybe. I put in maybe the count. Yeah, this is, I think, what makes sense. So let's go here. And what we'll do is just simply, okay, on copy button. Ah, let's leave the lock in here. FM move mode is to false. We don't want to move files. What we want to do is copy files, and we set the FM source URL to a string. And this thing, yeah, it could be a translatable string. And then we put in the file names, not the file names, the amount of files. I think I will do it like this first, and we'll put in here, leave it like this, files, and put in here, this needs to be translated, and put in here the count of, okay, this would be one file if there's only one. That doesn't make sense to have one then. It doesn't matter. Put in clipboard count. Clipboard count. So this should work if I'm not completely mistaken now. And yeah, for this to work, let's touch some other documents like doc1.txt. doc2.txt. So I want to copy all of those text files. Let's go to documents and remove this one here. And what we want to do now is copy those into the documents folder with our new code. So if I'm not completely mistaken, this should work now. And yeah, let's try it. Just execute it. And then we'll see what will happen. now it started. We can go into select mode. And there we see a problem. I cannot select the last file because our bar is in the way. That's too bad. So what do I have to do now is let's try this copy. Only two files then. And of course when I have hit copy I have to go out of the selection mode. Okay. So one issue at a time. First of all I have to go out of the selection mode. This means multi-select equals false. And the other thing is, how do I change the size of the, so I can select the last, I have to change the size of the folder view, I think, to work, or hide it when we are at the end of the list. No, this hide thingy. No. We will resize it, I think. Makes more sense. So, we have the page here. Where do we have our list? Here we have our view. Anchors for parent. This we have to change. Width to parent. Width on height. To we ask if our multi-select, we have to give it a name, multi-select bar, what is it, if our multi-select bar is open, we want parent height minus multi-select bar height, else we want parent height. So this should then resize depending on the size of everything. So let's hit play again. And then we'll see what will happen. So, in theory it should now work, and in theory it should now allow us to copy stuff. So let's do this again. Select. Yeah, it's working. Now if the bar is open, you can see I can select the last. Again, I hit copy and it closes, and this will go down here again. Nice. I go to documents and paste three files and 1, 2, 3. Ah, it's working. Oh, wait a second. Doc text, doc one text, and doc one text should be doc two text. There's something wrong. Ah, okay. Just some visual glitch, apparently. Yeah, so it seems to work. Doc text, doc one text, doc two text. Yeah, this is nice, isn't it? So, multi-copy is working already. So, what the only thing that I need to do now, you saw it in multi-select bar here, copy, and do the same for the cut button. The only thing that, just copy this. And the only thing that I need to do is set this to true. That's a nice function because my FM helper function will take care of removing the files after the copy process is done if the move mode is set to true. It's written somewhere in here. So this means, this means that the move function, the cut function, will also work then without any issue. We can, if we want to check, we can check this out as well. Let's remove all the doc files then move them from our documents folder via the select option, and then we select all the files, and we select cut, and then we select paste three files, and the files are here. Again, it has a problem with stuff here, doc text, doc one text, doc two text. Okay, this is working nicely. It's not working nicely. Oh, we hit cut, didn't we? So it did not remove the files after copying it over. So, and the names are messed up. Here it's written doc2, here it's showing doc text. Here's doc1, this is doc. Okay. So we have an issue, because we clearly chose cut, and I had FM move to set to true. And then we have to really check what's going on. First of all, I want to make sure that it's not a refresh error in the file manager itself. No, it isn't. Okay, here it is. Clearly, so the names are correct. That's a bit of a stupid thing that it is having problems with the refresh, but we have this little guy here. What we can do is maybe put a function. It should not be in here, it should be in our open dialog. We should have a function called refresh. And the only thing it will do is simply do this here. Oops, not do this, it should do this here. And then we will call here simply refresh. And the same thing we will do but in open dialog after using the paste menu entry, we will do a refresh as well, so that it refreshes all the stuff and we have the same names in here. Because you can see that copying one file only will work without any issues, but copying multiple files it has problems refreshing the file names. So we will do this like this. Now the turn to the question why the moving option is not working. I have to take a look at, we have connections, yeah, we have connections to FM and on source URL change. Yeah, we'll set the paste menu entry value to true or false. On CP results change. If we show a message, that's also clear. Error pasting file or file operation successful. Why is FM helper not removing the file? Where do we have, we set the move mode, yeah? Yeah, and it should remove the source URL here. This is what's written here. So after every copy process is done, basically, it should remove the file one after one. So it should work. If it's a directory, it will remove the directory. Otherwise, it will remove the file. Let's try it again. Let's see what will happen. We have here QDebug output as well. maybe we get some debug output that can be helpful. Let's see if it will work now, first of all with the refreshing stuff. And yeah, with the document stuff here as well. Good thing is I can of course remove two files here as well, just for setting delete here. I'm not sure if you need the delete button function in the multi-views thing, not sure. Let's select again all three files, hit cut. Let's double check if cut is doing the right thing. Cut is setting move mode to true. Yes. And yeah. So cut should do everything correctly. I don't want this or this. So we have doc text. We have doc 1 and doc 2 text. They are added to our path. Now I hit cut. Okay, cut is executed. Now I hit paste. Doc 1, doc 2. So now you can see the refresh thing is working. Now what's doing? CP result true. Source URL free files. File operation succeeded. CP result true. Source URL empty. Empty or full file. Remove empty or full file name. So here we have the problem. File operation succeeded. Here we have the issue, and now I know why in my FM helper I have the source URL in here, because as you can see here, msource URL, it is removing the msource URL. And the msource URL we set to free something files, which is of course not a valid file name. So what I have to do now is, of course I didn't know about it, it's so long ago that I coded this. What I have to do now is change this stuff. So I have to set the fmsource URL every time when I paste stuff. So I have to do it a bit differently here. So what you have to do here is do it a bit differently. So I really have to do it a bit differently from the perspective of how it works from the user. I need to do it later on, but what I have to do right here right now is set it really also to clipboard get 0.source. So it gets the correct source kind of thing. What I have to do as well is when I'm in open dialog and have my paste function. Where is it here? Paste menu entry. Is of course this needs to be done as well. I have to do it a bit differently. What I have to do here is, instead of using clipboard get I source, is I have to really set fm source URL to this source, and then use fm source URL to this. The clipboard get I name should be okay, so no problem with this. It should work now. So now the cut function should work, I think. If I'm not doing anything completely wrong, we'll test this out again by removing all the files from here, and then let's close this down, rerun it, and then we'll see that it will not look as good as I imagined first for the user, but this will work now just by simply Yeah, showing the right files that I cut. So the cut function needs to be. It's a bit tricky, so I need to have another solution for this. So again, select mode, select all of those files, cut, go back, and paste. Now you can see it only lists doc text because it's the first file. And now we have doc text, doc one text, doc two text. Let's see documents. Ooh, documents has doc text and doc one text. So doc two it removed, but it didn't remove doc one or doc text. So the theory that I had is not working here because it is starting. Yeah, I know now what the issue is. It's starting the copy process. Starting the copy processes, three different copy processes at the same time, and the FM source URL will be set to the last of the for loop here, and so it will only remove the last one but not the other one, the previous one. So this is not going to work. So what I'll do now, right now, is make undo this because this looks a bit better, and I have to really go into FM helper and change the code here. With the CP finished stuff, it should remove the file that it copied from. How do I do this? Ba -ba 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 -ba. So this will only, of course, remove the file if the move mode is turned on and the copy process finished. And the CP finished needs not only the finished result, but it also needs the source file that I copied. So where do I have the CP function? Here's the CP function. Checks for if it's a D or not. And we have a watcher here, which is for this finished signal, and then it gives it the CP finished kind of. It goes to the finished. And it's running the CP file target. This is just a fancy way of doing copy process in the background, so you can still that the UI will not hang, and you can still get a nice progress indicator that stuff is going on. This is why it's a bit in a complicated way done here. So we have the source here and the target here. Maybe it makes sense to really do the clipboard inside of C++ instead of QML. Oh, iterating through the QML list in C++ instead of the function here. Or I need to the source and target need to give the CP finished slot also the source as well, which would make sense, and then I can remove the source. I think this is what I will do. Just writing source inside of here will not work, I think. The CP finished slot, where we have the CP finished slot. Yes, CP finished slot, and it's accepting same as this. As a const. is accepting consisting source, and what it will do is then set the file info to source and then remove the source. So if I'm not thinking, if I'm not doing anything incorrectly with this const, I'm not sure if it is possible to give him, give the slot, it should be possible to give the slot a parameter. Where is it? Scrolling too much. Here, copy file. So give a slot a source like this. We'll see if it'll work out or not. First of all, let's remove all the files again. And then we'll see if it will work out or if it will bail out. Or if it compiles. Well, I think it compiles in the deploying phase now. Question is if it's doing the right thing. So now we have two files here. Could just create another file. Documents, doc tool, text to make this test working again. Cut, go back, paste, it's pasting all the files in here, and it's telling me there's no such slot fmcp finished source. So in documents I have all the files because it's not going there. This is why it's still circling around. So the slot stuff is wrong. What should I put in here? Signals and slots. Do we have some example files here for slot? For signal, now we have something for future. Wanted something for signal. Signals and slots, we can also use our browser. Qt signal and the slot with parameters. And signal didn't put it into signal. It needs to have a Q strings. Let's see. Yeah, but this is then for the signal to send a Q string to the slot. We want to give it a custom parameter that the signal is not sending. But that might be interesting, because then we have to edit the signal, probably. This won't work with it. Here's another option how to do it. I really have to search signal and slot const parameters. The problem is that so for those of you who didn't understand the problem is that the signal finished is sending some giving some parameters to the slot already, and the signal is firing the slot, And I cannot give him the slot a parameter if the signal is not sending it. So what I need to do is basically edit the signal to send my source as well. I'm not sure if this will work, I have to say. Could be that it's searching now for a signal called only finished, and there's no signal with source inside. So this would be bad, I think. And of course, this needs to be changed to QString. Well, we'll see what will happen. I don't think that the signal exists, the finished signal with the source inside, because it's only checking for existing signals. I have to edit the signal somewhere. I need to do it a different way. It doesn't work with the signal and slot kind of thing. But I will figure it out later, and then I will tell you how I did it. But this is everything but the second part, and you can see most of the stuff.